What's up, everyone? This is Derek. This is my last time, I believe, doing a vlog without a camera. So next week I should have a camera. I had an amazing week last week. How was yours? You can write me about it. But anyway, my grandma is at the doctor's office, so I can walk around the house naked if I wanted to because I'm home alone, and it's rare that I'm home alone, but I don't do that type of stuff anyway. But it is cool to be home alone every once in a while. So I guess I will start with last Friday. I went ahead and got a register on the way to the show, and they were out of the registers at Office Depot, so we went to this one in Pensacola. We got it. It was cool. And then I had to stop at the USS Alabama because I'm doing a show there on May 9th, the battleship on the Battle of the Bands. So I met with the lady who does the leasing of the ship there, and then I saw this helicopter going around. I was like, that'd be cool to have it there for the concert. So I got in touch with the pilot. He called me Monday. They're gonna come out there and do like helicopters, and I'm gonna get in the helicopter and do filming of the concert from above and downtown Mobile. And it's gonna be cool because we're out on the deck and you can see the skyline of Mobile, and it is actually getting a skyline now, which is cool. And then after that, me and my grandfather, he wanted to eat, and he wanted to eat at a restaurant. And I said, well, can we eat at a fast food place? And he's like, no, I want you to take me to a restaurant. So go to this restaurant, and he's eating, and he's a slow eater anyway. And so we get done, and we're halfway like to Gulfport or Biloxi, and I say, we're not gonna make it on time to the TV station, are we? And he's like laughing or whatever, and he's like, no, we're not. And I just got like so livid, and I could have been a lot more worse than I was, 'cause I used to get really like a bad temper tantrum, especially when I was younger. But thank God I'm not like that anymore. Easier to deal with. But anyway, we got off the interstate, and we were sitting in traffic, and they were doing construction on Highway 90 in Biloxi, and we were going like 5 miles an hour, and I just wanted to like crawl out of my skin. I was so upset that I was missing this, because these interviews are really important to me right now, because I'm gaining experience for, when I have to deal with national media and representing what Rock Summit's about. So I don't want to look like, when I get to that point, like a person that doesn't know what they're talking about, or just not be comfortable with media and stuff like that. So I was really upset I missed it, but I did get to the TV station. I saw where they were talking about Rock Summit, and they gave this girl tickets, that won tickets on the show, and one of the bands that was playing Rock Summit was performing, so I saw that part, but I just missed my segment. And then we actually went to the show, and some of the people saw it on the news, which was cool. And at the show, there was a lot of people there. It did really well, so I was happy about that. There was a few drunk people, and it's really weird seeing people, because I've been able to go to all my shows now, without drinking anything, and seeing like how weird people act when they're drunk, and it's just like, I can't believe I ever drank. Why did I do that? But yeah, I'm still kind of struggling with that. Easter Sunday was 6 months clean. I'm really excited about that, and I was like, that must be a sign or something, because I didn't, stop by any means on purpose 6 months ago. It just kind of happened, and it happened to be my 6 month was Easter. But anyway, so I'm gonna be able to get a lot of supplies now for Rock Summit. I'm taking April pretty much off from Rock Summit, just doing regular concerts or shows. And I've learned, I feel better about my career when I say I am a concert promoter, because people call my shows concerts, but I used to think of them as, oh, they're just like, shows. But people call them concerts, and I've been, called concert promoter in newspapers and stuff like that. So now I'm really starting to feel like that. And now I feel like I'm really getting to that point of actually getting to the nationals, which is exciting. Next week I have a meeting. I think it's on Tuesday, but I have to get it moved to Friday with the city of Pensacola, because we're shutting down the streets, and I've already got the five bar owners that I'm dealing with for the National Rock Summit to commit to doing the events down there. So that's going to be awesome. And we're basically bringing 150 bands to Pensacola, probably August 30th, and it's going to be a huge event. Probably get a lot of local press. And then the other thing, real quick, because I've decided I'm moving back to New York City. It's going to be cool because I get to go to Peninsula Bar, and I also get to meet with a few marketing firms I have in mind that will help me brand Rock Summit and, come up with great, logos and graphics for it, so it'll be a real brand. And at the Peninsula Bar, I go to the top of the rooftop. And one of my favorite songs right now is Leaving by Jesse McCartney. And I'm leaving to New York, so I'm going to leave you guys with that. Plus, I'm leaving off of this. And I saw Britney last night on How I Met Your Mother, which is cool. And right now, I'm just going to practice on resting. And I've been going up to the roof here at the house and, sunbathing. It kind of makes me feel like I'm back in New York because I can hear the helicopters. But then I open my eyes and I realize that I'm not there, but I am very excited. I'm moving back. And that is about it. So I will talk to you guys later. And next time you see me, it will be on a video cam. So here is Jesse McCartney. Hey, baby girl, I've been watching you all day.
Hey, baby girl, I've been watching you all day. Man, the thing you got behind you is amazing. But this is what you should say. Why don't you tell him that I'm leaving, never looking back again? You find somebody who does it better than he can. No more making you cry, no more than gray skies. Girl, we flying on the G5, G5. And we're leaving, never looking back again. So call him shorty and tell him you found a new man. The one that's so, so fly, the one that keep you high. Have you singing all night, night, night.